Hello, my name is Najwa. This is Unscripted, okay? And so today our first topic to be discussed is premarital sex, okay? The causes, the negative effects, people would have other reasons why they would want to do it. So, and also the positive effects of that. I mean, that sounds very dramatic.
Okay,
so yes, let's start.
Our panelists for today.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm Najwa, okay, you already knew that. So let's move on to Annabelle, but she first be called Annabelle, yes. Anna, yeah. So this Annabelle, yes, our first panelist. Okay, she's shy.
Oh, it's so
nice. Let's move on to the line. There you have it, our beautiful and handsome panelists. Okay, so the topic for discussion today is premarital sex. Okay, so premarital sex to me is getting into sexual activity before marriage. Okay, that is from my point of view. Okay, so let's just move on to
Hello. So yes, we're Unscripted, and we are talking about premarital sex. The causes and the advantages and disadvantages, okay? And so, to me, personally, premarital sex is getting to sex before marriage, okay? But then, we have varied opinions, so let me just move on to Annabelle. So tell us our opinions.
As Nanaka said, for me, I think premarital sex is, sex before marriage. Yeah, so I think some of the causes of premarital sex are broken homes, like when parents are not together, because like the children see that their parents are not together, they don't see the love and everything, like they are not cared for it. So they intend listening to advice from other people, and
some parents to take care of their children, lead them into premarital sex, because some parents, they don't like provide their children with shelter, the basic needs. So since they don't have them, they'll go in for someone who can, like a boyfriend or someone who can take care of them. Yeah. So these things also, when they go in, the man will do them one corner. At times they become pregnant and it destroys their future, because they might have better chances in life, but because they engage in premarital sex, they become they stop schooling and they even become dropouts. Yeah, so that's my opinion on the causes of premarital sex. Yeah, the name is Amat.
So yeah, let's go to show girl. Yeah, so what do you think?
Okay, for me, I think premarital sex is engaging in sexually related activities until marriage. Nowadays, these opera soaps and stuff, they tend to show this sexually. Yeah, you know.
They show sexual aspect.
We the youth want to experiment it, so we tend to, you know, have sex with our crushes and our boyfriends and stuff. So that is also one cause of premarital sex.
Okay, so let's move on to our one and only EL
that
I missed.
Okay.
Yes, I think premarital sex. It's basically the cause of it is ignorance. The people on the courses of premarital sex and the effect it brings on society. So this is how we deal with the matter of premarital sex.
Let's talk about the effects of premarital sex. I mean, what would cause an enemy to get into premarital sex?
The effect of premarital sex, like it includes like sexually transmitted diseases like AIDS, gonorrhea, syphilis, and such diseases, candida, and the rest. Now these diseases they are deadly. So when who knows to come? They don't have your kid.
Okay, so
they don't have cure for you. But it's not all like
HIV, there's no cure.
Some sickness like HIV is, it will cure before. Like,
it cannot be cured.
But then it can just prevent it. Maybe if you're supposed to die in the next 2 years, you can try and help.
The person
like everyone will be like, yeah, there's this stigma on you, like, oh, you're the only pregnant person sitting in class, so you now you not be able to do a lot of things in class. You, exactly. Your voice cannot even be heard because they'll be like, after all, so I think that's one effect of marital sex. So my colleagues.
So okay, you personally, would you want, right? I mean, if maybe a classmate of yours gets pregnant, I mean, and they produce, it's right of yours, would you want to work with her like that? Like,
I wouldn't want, okay. It would depend, but then me, I'll feel pity for the person, but then I'll not say I wouldn't like to work with the person. Even though if I work with the person, it would be like if best of the team minutes we work with our
change my phone long time. So I forget.
And then you change your phone, then how were you able to
get
the number?
Like the number, I've saved my number in my phone, but I lost like the group and everything. I left the group inside. So, I no longer
still using the phone number.
I'm still using the same number, but like I saved some of the girls because I saved your contact, but I saw that you're looking good for me. You have bigger you chance.
So what if I was not the one?
But okay, I'll say that when I saw you, me now I see that.
When you saw me, you saw
me where? Like when I see your picture,
no, and I'm saying what if I'm not the one
who is. You cannot say you are not the one.
Maybe I'm using my sister or my friend
okay,
or someone.
That, when I saw the picture, like, I became
touched.
And then you asked me for my picture, and I sent a picture, and I was looking so angry.
Yeah, that's it. That's the thing you have done.
Yes.
One day, I saw a certain lady in a group. So, like, no, that one, it's not, it wasn't a group. A friend of mine gave me the girl's number. So, I was chatting with the girl. And she has written a certain nice DP. Oh, this girl is not so good. This girl, let me do what? Oh, I asked the girl to send me a picture. She sent me some foolish pictures. She's the one. Oh, not knowing me too. The girl that I'm thinking I said, it's not the one. So I asked my friend that the girl that like she gave the number to me. Was she the one? She said, oh no. Nah. So I showed the picture that she sent. She said, oh, she's not the one, but like she said it's the friend. So I asked her, why did she do that? She said, oh, like
she can't use her friend.
She told me that she's the one. I said, at least I asked them to send me a picture. She sent me a
picture. So I asked
them to send me a picture. Depending on the
picture. Okay, so let's move on to showing you. I mean, you had a personal experience. Okay, like, has any guy used a very funny trick to try to fool you? Like, that's it. Like, you know, for me personally, one guy.
For me, when I see a string number, I don't reply. Like, I know, like, but I'm not giving my number out. So this was like, it doesn't matter. Like, I was so interested to know who this was. I was like, oh, okay. And he saw my number in a group. Okay. I was like, hey. And he mentioned the name of the group. And I was like, and looking at the number of people in the group, like 200 plus, like, wow. So you, so then that means you've been doing this, I mean, a number of girls. Like, I'm about the 110 girl, you know. So I was like, seriously. And then I just sent him his picture, and he sent his photo. And I spotted him, like, I know him, like, he's on campus, I know him. And he expected me to send my picture back. I was like, nah, I'm not doing that. So, yeah, so he wanted me to, like, send him my picture so that, like, it started from there. So all of these things are petty things that these guys try to do. So if you see a guy like that with that symptom, like, who can't approach you wholly as a man and ask for the number, then please, just dump him like that. Okay, so yes,
some of the girls
the girl can see, you know, maybe this girl is my friend, and then I'm a very nice guy, so she likes me. And then, like, she will tell her friend that she give my number to her so that she chat. So I'll be there, and then she'll send me hi. She'll send me hi, maybe hi. Like, for instance, you say the guys, you send me hi. But with the guys, although we also ask hi, or who is this? And you mention this one. Then maybe the guy will try to like ask about different stuff. But later on, maybe not.
Same. My question is, when you try to propose to a guy, like when you try to propose to a guy,
is it right to propose to a guy?
Actually, I don't think it's not right because now the boys of today, if you
for dating, they take your leniency to be your weakness. Like, because they know that you love them and then you can't do anything without them. They'll just be fooling around, playing with your heart and all. But then when they realize that you've moved on, then they go around like spoiling your name.
They go around spoiling your name
to people that you've done this, you've done that, you've done this and that. I mean,
because when they don't know, that is when the like adolescents, all these adults, kids will come and then like you know, name them.
I think this is very true. We Africans, we don't really talk to our kids about sex at all. But if outsiders, the foreigners talk to their kids about sex and other stuff, but for we Africans, we don't do that. So I think our parents should talk to us about sex and other stuff.
But, so because of that, I think if our parents should talk to us about those things, even if we are facing those relationship problems, to be able to like go to them, open up to them and go like, mommy, daddy, this guy is worrying me, this, that. But since they don't give us that space, you know, I mean, how can I go and stand in front of my mother and be like, ah, boy, you don't want to go close to them to start to even bring a topic like that. Like, I know.
So when they are educated, like, it prevents teenage hate. Pre-marital sex and teenage pregnancy.
Abstain.
me saying that, how can you abstain? So just don't indulge in things that would trigger such emotions. Okay. Just
wait.
Okay. Like,
for instance, I have a girlfriend. Who likes the thing?
Do you have what? A girlfriend?
Like
the thing.
Like you, the thing. And then big.
But the only thing I'll advise you to do is then if you know that she likes them, you don't go to places that you guys be together, like your room.
Yeah, room.
You don't come to like every place, like the breeze, a restaurant. Ah, you can tell me that this you come in and have sex.
Romance
is different from sex.
And the romance to live in a
room.
Oh,
I
can also be the ladies also that make the guys
do
that.
We are pregnant.
Yeah, also it's the ladies that make them do that thing. Seriously.
Okay, I'll give you a next. I had a friend. Like one of my friends, my buddy. Ah, he told me that a girl came to his house. The girl was in straight dress, nothing, ready to do the thing. So the girl came to sit down and buy this inside like this. So the guy also didn't want to do it. We went out and went to call someone ready to shoot guy. So when the guy came up, I think they had to go have in the room. So the guy went outside and then saw everything they were doing. So you see, the girl was the one who the guy wasn't dating the guy, but like
she also doesn't mean you should just accept it. No, that it's wrong. You're a Christian, and it's very wrong.
So like your friend, like you know, you're dating now, you can't imagine.
You can do it. You broke your mind not to do it. That's why.
It can be like,
what's wrong with this?
The way that people look at you,
nah.
I
I don't think so. I mean, because it's they are selling it.
I
went to
get a friend to buy some. Because when I said it, I was so shy. People the man didn't even ask me.
Nah. Then why? I don't know. Yeah, then so why are they selling it? It shouldn't be so. Okay, you should work out. That's why they are selling it. If you know you won't sell it, then don't bring it to the shop to come and buy. So just go there, be bold. Okay, that is one of the things that we as Africans, that is what is worrying us. We are not bold. We can't speak out. Just speak out. No, your mouth was written for you to talk. So if something is worrying, just speak it out. Okay, so that is it. Okay, just abstain and use contraceptives. Okay, and then pre-marital sex is not for you. Okay, it's for sex is not for me, like for the unmarried ones. Okay.
For mommies,
it's for mommies and daddies.
Those with big powers.
You know,
yeah. And sex is actually designed for married couples.
Yes, designed for married couples. It's not for those who are single. That's it. So if you are single, yes, absolutely. Don't dare. Don't try move somebody's drawers. That is that. You don't try to unzip somebody's trouser. Yeah.
Let's be very realistic. Sex, I'm not saying I've done it before, but then one thing, sex is nice. Sex is very nice. It's for okay, for 90% of we, everybody, sex is something which is very pleasurable. It's for pleasure. Okay, so it's something that when you get into it,
you can never stop.
It's not easy for you to stop. Okay, and you have emotions. There'll be times that something will trigger. But then before, when you were in sexual action, when things like that happen, you can have a fear of controlling it. But then since you teach them it and you know how it feels, you'll be compelled to try to satisfy whatever pleasure that you have with them. Okay, so let's just very realistic. This is something that when you get to it, pleasure with God that designed it. So anything that God did, it's so nice. So yes, so it is nice. Even if you taste it, you can't stop. So please, if you don't want to incur any other stuff, then just don't taste it. Okay, and those of us, or those of them, I've not done it, but I'm just saying, those of them who have done it, please try. If you constantly do it, more for them, they can't get tired of it. And over there, it's elastic, it's very elastic. Contract. So, but it's not nice. Like, you get married to your future husband, and then you come there, and then it has already been adulterated. It doesn't satisfy
your white bedsheets, and then
So, let's just try and stick to our values, and then leave that. Okay, I know it's not easy, but those of you who are still in the district want to accept it, so as you don't get sexually transmitted, and also you don't end up getting pregnant. That is fine, but then let's just abstain. That is the ultimate point of solution for us. Okay, so thank you very much. And then please, let's just give our last words. Okay, so. I just hope you guys love it, okay?
let's watch out for subsequent interesting, more hot topics for discussion. And then you can send in your suggestions, your shout outs. If you have any issue that pertains to be the youth, you can bring it on so that we all discuss. No, we don't have all the worldly or all the perfect solutions for it, but then we can break it down in our own understanding, okay? In a way that we all share, have a sharing with that, so that it will be better explained to you, okay? So just send in your suggestions, your shout-outs, your comments, whatever that you have to say, regardless of it being negative or positive, just send it to us, okay? And we just, it's right for us, okay? I just hope you love that. So he has been me,
and Najwa, and then I have a team.
Annabelle
and Melanie.
Yeah.
And Matt.
Yeah.
And that's Miguel.
Yes. He's great. Don't worry. But the subsequent ones we've seen today, it feels like a bit a little bit under the weather.
He's just saying.
So,
yes.
What? Okay, let's go to
the
So yes, it has been Raw Unscripted. Don't get a script. You can follow us on our social media handles. On our social media pages, sorry. Instagram is Raw_Unscripted. Facebook, Raw_Unscripted. Wherever. Just go and then search for us, okay? And then they will love us, okay? Just watch out. And then stay blessed, okay? And then be you, okay? Bye-bye. We love you.